Hello everyone, today we'll do the subject geography of grade 6 and our chapter number 6 is importance of oceans. How oceans are important for us. So we will discuss in this lesson the importance of ocean. In previous year, we have already studied about spheres. So there are three spheres, that is lithosphere, hydrosphere and atmosphere. In lithosphere, it is consist of land. Atmosphere consists of air and hydrosphere is consist of water, that is water body. So in this chapter, we will discuss about hydrosphere. Let us start with constituents of hydrosphere. What are the constituents of hydrosphere? That is include water bodies. So there are different kinds of water bodies. For example, oceans, seas, rivers and their tributaries, that is lakes, groundwater, etc. This all including water bodies. Next point, covers all oceans. These water bodies, they cover all the oceans. Because in ocean, it is include as seas, river, tributaries. So these all are together cover all the oceans. Next, global water 97.7%. So all over the world we have from 100% we have 97.7% water, that is lakes, seas or oceans. So this all comes under global water. So we have oceans water, that is 97.7%, and the rest of 0.03% only we have fresh water, that is potable water. Next point, activity. So I am telling you one activity, that is a very simple activity. Just in one plate, just take a stuffed rice. Stuffed rice means poha, and you have to mix turmeric, then chili powder, onions, tomato, chopped and mix it well. And in another plate, again take stuffed rice, that is poha, and mix all these ingredients with salt. In first plate, you don't have to add salt, but in second plate, you have to add salt. Now just taste the first plate poha. So what do you feel? You feel tasteless, means you didn't like that taste. But when you taste this second plate poha, so you will like the taste. Why it is so? Because in first plate we are not add salt, but in second plate we have add a salt. So salt give us taste. So we will interestingly or enjoyingly we eat the food. So salt is very much important for us. So let us discuss salt in water. Everybody knows that in water salt is present. In drinking water quite low, but in drinking water, in fresh water, potable water, salt proportion is very less, very low in proportion. But in oceanic water, salt proportion is very high. Next, greater amount of salt in ocean and seas tastes salty. Means that ocean water and seas, rivers water, in that water, salt proportion is very high. That is greater in proportion. That's why that water tastes salty. But in drinking water, the amount of salt is very less. That's why we are not having the taste of salt. Next, causes of increase in the level of salt and minerals, ocean water. What are the causes and why these causes are increases in salt and minerals of oceanic water? So let us see. Decomposed in oceans. Decomposed in oceans means the remains of aquatic life or aquatic animals or aquatic life like trees, corals, reefs, these are comes under aquatic life. So the remain of this aquatic life, they decompose in the water. This is the reason that causes of oceanic water increases, because the death parts of this thing, this remains in the water, this decomposes in the water. So that's the reason that another aquatic life also suffer. Next, volcanic eruption. Adding of different types of minerals, ashes, salts and other thing which is present in the water, this may cause volcanic eruption. These are the reason because of this thing volcanic eruption also occur. So this is also the causes. So here continuous evaporation increases salt. So the continuous evaporation, that is water cycle, if this is continuously going same like this, so it also increases the salt. Next, salinity of ocean water. Salinity means salt in water or soil. Expressed in terms of means, this salinity is always expressed in terms of means. Like for example, we are using thermometer. So in thermometer, it expressed in terms of degree. Same like that, salinity is expressed in terms of means per 1000. That is, average salinity is 35 per 1000. The average salinity, minimum, that is 35 per 1000. Same like that, in that sea, they have minimum salinity is 332 per 1000. So, these are the measures of salinity in oceanic water. Next point. Salt pans and salt and minerals. How salt pans obtain or occur? How salt we get? Let us see. By constructing salt pan in coastal areas. Coastal areas means near or close to coastal line is known as coastal areas. Salt is a substance that we have to construct salt pan in coastal areas. In coastal area means in boundaries of coastal areas. In that place we can easily obtain salt. So we have to construct salt pan. Next point, diet item. Salt is also a diet item. Means we are using salt in our food item. So it is also known as diet item. Next, obtain minerals. Like salt, we also obtain different kinds of minerals like phosphate, sodium, iodine, etc. from the seas. Next point, fish and other marine animals. Other marine animals means other aquatic animals. Get fish from seas, rivers and lakes. We get aquatic animals like fish, crabs, prawns. That we all get from seas, rivers and lakes. In seas is such greater than in river and lake. We want more fishes. So we get that more fishes or more aquatic animal from seas instead of river and lakes. In river and lakes we get a small amount of aquatic animal. But in seas we get larger amount of aquatic animal, that is fish and other marine animals. Ancient occupation. Catching fish and other marine animal is the basic and ancient occupation of that human beings. In past time, they used to catch fish and other marine animals for their daily purpose or for their day-to-day life. Next, used for preparing food item. They also use this aquatic animal for preparing a food. Producing fertilizer, pharmaceuticals, etc. These also are uses of marine animals. Trees, island like Seychelles, Mauritius, Maldives, etc. Their life depend on sea. Means in these countries or island, the people, their life depend on aquatic animal or in seas. Next, nearness to the sea. Nearness means close to the sea. Continentality and temperature. So in the region close to the ocean, because of the heating of sea water, means in this region where the ocean is close to each other, in that place their temperature, their sea water level is heating. the temperature is heating. The sea water level is also heat up. See, water vapor mixed in the air. So there water vapor means steam. So that water vapor that mixed with the air, this water vapor holds the heat in the air and there remains humid. And afterwards what will happen? Water vapor, they holds the air. And because of that thing, that temperature, that climatic condition will be humid. Next, region close to the oceans have an equal climate. The area which is close to the ocean, their climate will be equal. Okay. Next, region far away from the ocean. Here we have seen close to the ocean. Now in this, the area which is far away from the ocean, the amount of water vapor is extremely less. Because they are far away from the ocean, so the water vapor also have less amount. As its effect, the air remains dry. That's why the air is dry in that particular region. Region far away from the ocean have extreme climate. Their climatic condition is extreme. Next point, pressure belt and winds. What are the effect of pressure belt and winds? Equatorial region receive perpendicular sun rays. In a globe, we have equatorial region means equal part. Then we have torrid region. Then we have frigid region. Frigid region means polar region. So here, equatorial region receive perpendicular sun rays. This straight, perpendicular to one another. So they get perpendicular sun rays. This region get more heat. That's why the region is very hot, because they get more heat. Polar region receive extremely slanted sun rays. Polar region, that is frigid region, cold region. So they get slanted sun rays. Slanted sun rays means like this, slope. Like this, slanted sun rays. So that's why they get less heat. Because the sun rays is not in perpendicular. So in polar region, it means the climate is cold, because they get slanted sun rays. Next, create imbalance in the temperature of air in different parts. Because of this sun rays, they get imbalance in environment, and this is the reason they have different air in different part of the region. Formation of high and low pressure belt on the earth. So this is the reason, because of this they get formation of high and low pressure belt on the earth. Wind blow to pressure differences in this belt. The air which blow, that air is also different in different kind of region. These winds are called planetary winds. Ocean current, planetary winds moves the oceanic water in the form of current is known as ocean current. So we have two types of ocean current. First is warm ocean current and second one is cold ocean current. So in warm ocean current, they move from equatorial to polar region. Means in the globe, from equatorial to polar region they move. And in cold ocean current, flow from polar to equatorial region, vice versa. Here they move from equatorial to polar, and in cold they flow from polar to equatorial region. Next, redistribution of heat on the earth. This warm oceanic current leads to redistribution of heat, means the warmness, that's they redistribute the heat on the earth. And in cold ocean current, they increase the temperature of the polar region. Next one, water cycle. Everybody know that is water cycle, evaporation, condensation, this all comes under water cycle. So vast expanse, ocean have a vast expanse, means the oceans are explored, a vast area, wide area. So this come under vast expanse. Vapor is created because of this water cycle, they create vapor. Next, earth gets rainfall. Ocean is the reason, from this ocean the earth gets rainfall and they also have source of rain. Ocean is the source of rain. Next, rain water flow from lakes and streams finally flow back into ocean. The rain water in water cycle means that condensation, evaporation, then precipitation. This cycle continuously goes on and on like that. This rain water from the sky, that rain water flow from lakes and the stream, then they join the ocean also. Now, the beginning and end of the water cycle goes on and on, same. Next, oceans and resources. From ocean, what resources we are getting? So here first is minerals. We get minerals like iron, lead, cobalt, sodium, manganese, chromium, zinc, etc. Next, precious item. We also get precious item from oceans, that is pearls, corals, ornamental items and shells. Food items, we get food items like prawns, clams, crabs, shellfish, mackerel, pomfret, Indian shark and Indian salmon. We also get mineral oil, natural gas and medical plant from oceans and resources. And these are the resources from which men do their occupation. Next point, oceanic transport. We are doing business, we are going from one place to another place. So in this topic we will discuss oceanic transport. First is economic transportation. Economic means business, trade. We are migrate from one place to another place, or import and export our business or material from one place to another place, that is economic transportation. Next, international trade. Not only in India, we transport or we expand or explore our trade in international level also. So this will also include in international trade, that oceanic transport also help us to transport our business international level. Next, countries like Spain, Norway, Japan gain importance in water transport. So these are the countries, they gain importance. This transport is very much important for this kind of countries, that is Spain, Norway and Japan. By waterways we can export or import many things, that is bulky materials. Like bulky materials means heavy and lots of materials together, is known as bulky materials, like coal, crude oil, raw materials, metallic materials, food grain, etc. can transport with very easy way, that is water way. Now, ocean currents, accurate speed of ships and safe fuel. Long oceanic current, which is present in ocean, that is large or bigger waves, that help us to move quickly from one place to another place, that is accurate speed, means in quickly speed. Within a couple of minutes or within a few minutes, we can transport from one place to another place very quickly, and it also save our fuels. So it means that long ocean current save our time, effort and fuels. Next, issues related to ocean. What are the issues that related to ocean? First and very important issue, that is oil spills. The oil which are transported from one place to another place, that oil flow down in the sea, it is known as oil spills, that is escape to the sea. Next, product. The waste material which is released from coastal areas that we produce in the river or seas. So this also cause big issue. Next, seepage released by industries. The waste material which is released from the industrial areas, waste be thrown in the sea. So it is known as seepage released by industries and cities, etc. Caused pollution. This all are the reason which cause pollution, that is water pollution, and it is very much harmful to our aquatic animal or aquatic life. Last, many aquatic animals are under the threat of being extinct. Threat means danger. Because of this all issues, many aquatic life are now in threat, that is now they are in danger and they are come to an extinct. Extinct means end. Their life will be end very soon. So we have to be very careful, and for our goodwill we should not harm other aquatic life. They also have life, they also have to enjoy it, and we have to do something like that which does not cause pollution and which does not harm aquatic animals.